We did our first harvest of green chilies and we picked almost 147 chilies. It was a good amount of harvest that we had. So let's get straight into our harvest.
Here we have a couple of chili plants. So here you can see there are around 15-20 chilies in this from just the shoe plants. This is another section where I have most of my plants. This plant in particular had lot of chilies in it, and let me tell you, the leaves of this plant were not that great. It had some curling issues, but still it gave lot of chilies. By lot I mean 15-20 chilies when I compare it with other plants that I have. You may be wondering why we are taking this video on a day when there is so much of rain and background noise. So the reason is I saw some couple of chilies on the plants which were turning brown and they were going bad actually, and I felt it was because of the rains, because only after the rain started I saw them going bad. And I thought we did so much of hard work to grow all this green chilies and it should not go waste. So let's just harvest all the ones that are ready to harvest. So here is one example of the green chili turning brown and squishy and bad. It turned out to be a good decision because the next 1 week we had non-stop rains. And if the reason for this couple of chilies going bad was the rain, then there could have been more chilies that could have gone bad. So, yeah. Now this is one of the best plants that we have in my balcony. In the beginning when these plants were growing, suppose if you had asked me to pick one plant, I don't think I would have picked this one at that point of time. But later on, so it wasn't that great in the beginning. Later on it picked up good growth. It was really tall in the beginning, tall and leggy, so I was not expecting it to become bushier. But now here it is nice and bushy and it has given lot of green chilies also. So I'm happy about it. So that way these plants, you know, they keep on surprising you. Thank you. Wow, look at all those green chilies. Now this plant, it started blooming very late, but it had a very nice and thick trunk at the base. So that kind of showed me that, you know, when it starts blooming, it will have a lot of chilies, and it did. And obviously, this is one of my favorites. On the other hand, this plant, you know, I'm plucking this one big chili out of this. It had a lot of blooms in the beginning, and I thought this will have a lot of chilies. But unfortunately, I don't know why, but almost 80% of the blooms, they fell off. And hardly there were 3 to 4 chilies, but the size of these chilies were really good. So I'm hoping in the next harvest, this might have more number of chilies. Now we have picked most of the green chilies, and we are just going through all the plants once again, just to see if we have left out any. So we got another 3-4 of chilies. So I have kept some plants in a windowsill as well. So these are few of them. That's it. That's the entire harvest of the day. And it's kind of unbelievable, because in the beginning I was not expecting these many chilies in the first harvest itself.
Hello, so I hope you liked all the video clippings that I took that day. All these plants are 5 months old, and all of them started from seeds. So there was just one red chili that we brought from Kerala. Just market brought chili, and I took all the seeds from that one chili and grew all these plants. So it is possible to have so many plants from just one ripe red chili. So the color of all the chilies are slightly different. I mean, they are not so consistent, but a lot of variety, and I actually like that. Some are thick, some are little longer and slimmer. Comparatively, when I compared this with the market brought chilies, color is a bit darker, so that's what I observed. So let's just cut one. So I've taken one more chili to show you, and okay, let me just cut it like this.
Now can you see all the juice that is there? So many seeds, and we actually tasted. I mean, we have been using only our chilies since last week in our cooking, and they have really good amount of heat content. So even the heat quotient is also good of all the homegrown chilies, and it was all organic. There was no chemical used in the entire growing of this green chilies.
So that is it for today's video. And thank you for stopping by and watching. If you have any comments, do share it with me, and we'll be back with another video soon. Thank you and bye.